I can't but help to expose the truth about even your great black inventors. For starters, Garrett Morgan did not invent the traffic light. The modern traffic light was created by a white police officer named William L. Potts in 1920. Potts' invention was not adopted until years later by lighting manufacturers. Morgan was just lucky. His vastly inferior version of Potts' creation was gobbled up by General Electric. And how about the father of all black inventors, George Washington Carver? The man who had claimed to have hundreds of different inventions, including many different uses for peanuts, none of which he documented. None? The man did not even invent peanut butter. An unknown doctor did in the 1890s, and a doctor in St. Louis, Missouri named Ambrose Straub invented the first machine for making peanut butter. Yet ignorant men will honor these non-innovators as the true creators. Lies as truth? Listen up, black Americans. When will you learn to take responsibility for your own actions? When are you going to build up your communities instead of tearing them down? When are you going to stop peddling the worst people in your society as the best people in your society? You proudly parade yourselves as pimps, prostitutes, derelicts, and deviants. And you wonder why Dr. Laura Schlesinger said what she said. I give her credit. Because she told the truth. You are a self-depreciating people with little dignity left. Most of you go to church on Sundays, and then act a fool for the next 6 days. But still call yourself Christians, though you have little to no demeanor resembling that of Christ. Black men, all you do is talk about how many women you can run over, calling them bitches and whores, good-for-nothing sluts. Beating them up, because it makes you feel manly, or what you think is manly. Fathering 11 kids, but not giving a hoot about a single one. Black women disrespecting yourself by calling yourself a hoe, bitch, slut, and not caring which man screws you to death then leaves you with the 5 kids. I know this. Though this is not all of your community, however the bulk of your community, and dare I say the majority of your community, favors this lifestyle. The majority of black America today is a disgrace. What do they care about? Being the biggest fornicators. Men saying they have the biggest dicks, women having the biggest asses, having the biggest foul mouths, the biggest thugs, the biggest sluts, the biggest drug users, having the cars with the biggest rims, spending up all your dough, and then robbing your best friend blind, because you have no financial discipline. No wonder blacks in America are the most scrutinized ethnic group. Us white people know this, my brethren in the Jewish community know this, my brethren in the Asian community know this. My brethren in the Hispanic community know this. My brothers in the black African community know this. And the best educated people of your community that don't partake in this crap, a sad minority I am sure, because you killed off or turned out most of them because they weren't black enough, know this. But you fail to grasp this. Worse, you are not only trying to turn out them, but also the rest of America, and the world, especially the youth, and the liberal members of society that have tolerated and embraced the idiocy of your shenanigans. And man, when Obama got elected, many blacks thought they were embarking on a journey to heaven. That they would never have to work anymore, that everyone would get free welfare and health insurance. Wow, what a difference 3 years make. And if you think I'm just knocking on the Democrats and liberals, you are 100% wrong. I also fault some Republicans for their irresponsibility when they elected the incompetent Michael Steele, a fast-track spur of the moment choice to head the Republican National Committee, who was embroiled in scandal. Really, I can't help to say that with people like this, why should we be forced to have an entire month devoted? Really, it's time to con Black History Month, because moreover anything it discredits and belittles the legacy of the competent blacks of history that fought for freedom and civil rights. And the competent, hard-working blacks in America today. The ones that work hard, pay their taxes, raise their children, believe in God, in Christ, and respect themselves. Especially the good, decent African Americans that want nothing to do with the abominations that have sadly dominated their race. The rest of you need to take a page from them and get your act together right now. And stop wishing to make yourselves independent of America while enjoying the benefits of being American. If you want to do so, pull your monies together by a boat and go back to Africa. Chris Rock was right. There are two kinds of black people in America, black people and niggers. And the niggers have got to go.